Good afternoon, everyone. Myself, Kushal Kapoor. I'm working as a postdoctoral fellow at University of Western Cape, Cape Town, South Africa. I joined a couple of months back and I'm working on the development of new laboratory detector facility coming up at our university. So I'll be giving a brief introduction of what kind of work we are doing and the applications for the work. So the talk is oriented, I'll briefly introduce the work which I am doing, then the items which are purchased so far for the establishment of this new laboratory at our university. And basically this laboratory is based on digital signal processing, so I will be briefly discussing about how this digital signal processing takes place. And then the development work that have been done so far, and then finally to the conclusion. So just a brief introduction to my university where I'm working. The University of Western Cape consists of diverse student bodies, mainly consisting students from historically disadvantaged backgrounds in South Africa. In previous couple of decades, the university has performed seriously very well and is now Department of Physics, Nuclear Physics Division is known as one of the best performing department in whole South Africa. I'm not claiming it, just for an introduction. So the nuclear physics group at UWC performs experiment at Ithemba Labs, and there is no tradition of in-house development of apparatuses, and we at the partner universities such as University of Zululand or University of Western Cape or Wits University in South Africa. So we basically buy operators from the international laboratories or private companies. So an initiative was taken by Professor Nico Orte from Department of Physics, University of Western Cape, Professor Sufiso from University of Zululand, in association with Professor David Jenkins from University of York. They wrote a proposal to STFC, Science Technology Funding Council, to develop this new detector facility which can give a hand-on training to the students for the signal processing and detector application. So finally we got this lab sanctioned, and as a result I was selected as a postdoc in this laboratory. So this the aim of this laboratory is to develop a strand of nuclear application work at UWC, University of Zululand, in partnership with University of York, England. In addition to this laboratory, we have various international collaborations where we see it was recently our group has performed an experiment at CERN with a Isolde facility, and it was claimed that it was the first African-led experiment at Isolde. In contrast to that, our group has been performing experiments at Triumph, obviously at our local labs, Ithemba. Couple of experiments we keep on performing. For this experiment, David Jenkins was also in news for this high funding for this laboratory. So the items purchased so far, we bought couple of PIXI 16 modules in order to get this digital signal processing thing working. We get this PXI crate from Germany, then PXI to PCI controller, which is used for the communication of this PIXI 16 modules with the host computer. We bought a high-speed PC, and in addition, this PIXI 16 module consists, as shown over here, have 16 input channels which are made in four quads arrangement. Whole of this setup is power backed with a high power UPS in order to avoid unwanted accidents due to power failure. So this is just for a demonstration. This is how our lab looks like. It looks very nice, and it has been organized in a way that we can accommodate a lot of new detector facilities in this room. So me with my colleagues working in this lab. So the one of the major thing requirement to get this system running is the firmware for PIXI 16, which needs to be very carefully interfaced with the DAC so that the DAC system can read what kind of detector signal PIXI 16 is getting. So the preamplifier signals are digitized are digitized from the individual detector and fed to the FPGA unit. FPGA units are the field programmable arrays. These, in a general terms, FPGAs are the brain of PXIE16, which is used for the communication as well as which gives us the identification of the signals. So this is the basic structure of PXIE16 module. These are the input slots for PXIE16. As soon as the PXIE16 gets a signal from the preamplifier, it gets converted into digital form, and then this digital signals are fed to the FPGAs. These FPGAs give us the timing and the energy signals from the detector. To control these FPGAs, we have two algorithms, which are known as the slow and the fast filters. These filters are respectively used for the timing and the energy signal from the nuclear detector. At the end of these four FPGA, there's a system FPGA, which after every iteration, it keeps on communicating with the individual FPGA just to verify that the pole zero and the pile-up corrections are going fine and the real decay of the signal is being recorded. So this process is handled by a clock unit, which is an intrinsic part of this PXIE16. So these are the buses, data buses, and a buffer unit, which stores the individual iteration or individual event information in this. So in addition to this, we have a plan to take this this whole setup to Ithemba labs or to other international laboratories where we need to do this gamma-gamma coincidence experiments. For this, we certainly need a Compton suppression. For the Compton suppression, PXIE16 gives us a very nice feature where approximately 16 HPG crystal input can be given as a veto signal to from an Ethernet cable to this PXIE16, which cancel out my unwanted events from the data, and it reduces my unwanted data by great fraction. So this is how basically my preamplifier signal looks like. As soon as the clock pulse goes one, my preamplifier signal starts getting sampled. So how does this PXIE16 knows that is it a recordable signal or not? There are two kind of triggers, which are good triggers and the bad triggers. PXIE16 automatically rejects the bad triggers, and once this pulse goes high, it starts sampling. And at the each pulse, clock pulse, as it goes one, the corresponding value for the pulse gets stored in the buffer unit of PXIE16. This whole setup is controlled. The recording of this pulses can be elaborated using this diagram, which says the whole algorithm can be controlled using the rise time and the flat top of the signal, where L gives the length and G represents the flat top of the signal. So we basically require two major information, that is energy and the timing. So the whole FPGA units are controlled using these two algorithms, which gives the slow filter gives me the amplitude of the interaction or the energy which is brought in by the particle hits the sensitive area of the detector. And the fast signal gives me the trigger of the this pulses which are being recorded by the detector. So this is the actual picture which we finally, after doing all this survey, we made this setup. These are some essential components which are used to 1 minute. So which you used for this whole setup is a PXIE16 module. At the brain of this is the controller unit. This is a PCI card which goes inside the motherboard chassis of a high computing PC. So in addition, this was all about the hardware setup. I've been working on the DAC software for the development of the DAC. Once this firmware was interfaced we set an experiment for the testing of the sodium iodide detector, and these are my optimized parameters to get the best resolution, and these were tested with the two sources. Resolution of a detector was tested, was studied with as a function of various parameters such as rise time, trigger rise time, flat top, tau, all these parameters. On the basis of this, I have written a computer code in C++ where we just need to give an input for the characteristics of the signal, that is the rise time and the decay. It automatically calculates all the 9 parameters which can be fitted, given to get the best resolution of the detector. So another thing which we are interested in doing the particle gamma coincidence experiment at our laboratory, for which I have designed this vacuum chamber, and we are hopeful that this chamber will be will come to our laboratory within a couple of weeks. And this is under manufacturing process at the University of Stellenbosch, Cape Town. So this is a top view of the chamber. And once this system comes to our university, we will be able to test our PIXI-16 and all other kind of setups. So future plan is like that we plan to build our PIN diode array with and cesium iodide array. We also plan to make our gas detector, for which we are planning to start our work very soon. Then the major role of this laboratory is to train our graduate and undergraduate students, the postgraduate students, for signal processing using analog and the digital signal processing terminology, for which we already have various detectors such as segmented silicon detectors, sodium iodide and silicon. And this gives our student a hand-on training, and they learn better before going to some international laboratory for performing some nice Coulomb excitation or other kind of experiments. Recently, we signed an MOU with the Tigerberg Hospital at Cape Town for development of the PET detector and the scanners for detection of cancer tumors in the human body. So we are again starting this project very soon, and we have been appraised for this project a lot. Every year we organize a conference at our University of Western Cape. So we'll be discussing more about this new laboratory during this conference. This time this conference is at University of Zululand. I welcome all of you to please participate if interested. Thank you. So the conclusion for this talk is that we are developing a new detector facility where we want to train our students with both digital as well as analog signal processing for different kind of experiment. And we are designing vacuum chambers, we are working continuously on DACs, and basically we want to build up a portable and reliable detector system which can be taken to various international labs for the experiments. With this, I would like to thank you all for your kind attention. Thank you so much.